Hello you guys, welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is me, your very own Faith Lemtur. If you're new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel, and if you're old to my channel, then welcome back. So guys, today I'm basically gonna sit and talk, alright? I hope that is fine. So I'm gonna share my testimony of how my life has turned around, and I can't keep it to myself because it was led in my heart, and it is not about me, but it is about giving glory to Jesus. First off, I want to start with saying that Jesus loves you all immensely, and I don't know how many of you know this, but just know that Jesus loves you, alright? So, I've been a believer ever since my whole childhood, ever since I was born in a Christian family. Yes, and I accepted Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior according to Romans 10 verse 9 and 10. So that is a simple Bible verse, right? But it is so much more. It is so much more than what you know, right? So my father led me to this Bible verse. He told me about Jesus, and then he got me saved. I was baptized with the Holy Spirit. All done and dusted. So all my life I was a Christian, right? I was a strong believer, I would say, because I went to the church. I went to an amazing church where, you know, the Spirit of God, where God was moving mightily. I went to an amazing church where God was moving mightily. I knew about Jesus. I knew so much about Jesus. I knew about the Bible, whatever we were taught in the Sunday. I grew up when I was in my teenage, I went to the same church. It was perfect, you know. I was where God wanted me to be, and things were very nice. I knew about Jesus. I had everything that I required, and you know, whatever was required of me as a believer was being taught to me. So that's how I grew up. But I was a lukewarm Christian, I would say, because I was not living according to what the scriptures said. I was not really able to understand, you know, in deeper way of what Jesus really had for me. I came to Delhi in 2019, and when I was back home, I was rooted, you know. I used to go to church, so at least a thing was there. Like, I was, you know, it's not that easy for me, but okay, long story short, okay, I knew the Lord, everything. I was a believer, praise God. I used to pray in tongues, and you know, even there were times where I would lay my hands on people, I would pray. I have led people to Jesus. I have got them born again, saved according to Romans 10 verse 9 and 10. Yeah, and it was all great. As I grew up, you know, my priorities changed, and that's where things shook. So I came to Delhi in 2019, and at first I used to go to churches here and there. I didn't know, like, you know, I wasn't led by the Spirit, I would say, because if I was led by the Spirit, I would have been in the right place, and you know, I would have been still with the Lord. But that's past. We don't talk about the past. So I started working, you know. I started living according to how the world would live, and that is not what Jesus has called us for, right? In my heart I knew it, but physically I was not able to do it. I would pray in tongues even then, you know, but I was not going to church. I would attend my home church, about Dimapur's. I have a church in Dimapur that is still my home church, so I used to attend it online. But then when I started working, I started working on Sundays as well, and I do night shifts, so things came up, and I was like, okay, so now I'm doing the night shifts. So like, my problems were bigger than God in my life at to some point that I did not even realize then, all right? And then everything happened. Long story short, I went into depression, and it was like for 3 years I fought with it. I went suicidal, Did I know Jesus? Yes. Did I know His word? Yes. Did I read? Did I meditate the way I should? No. So there was something holding me back, and you know, I was not able to understand. My problems were just bigger than God at that point of time, that I could not see clearly. So it was the devil who had held me, caged me, and I was blinded. So I always wanted an escape from that. I was not happy doing what I was doing. I was not happy at all. I knew how I was raised. I was raised in a good family. I was raised where we knew Jesus. And I was like, what am I doing? I mean, you know, I was like questioning my self-worth. I mean, the devil was putting so many thoughts inside of me, and I was entertaining them. I would get anxiety and panic attacks when I would be all alone by myself. And sometimes I would think that I was dying because of those things that was happening to me. And I didn't really share it in detail with... I mean, God knows everything that I've been through. And right now, it is not about me, okay? It is about Him. So, I came to know about FOLJ Church, alright? And after so many years, I was like, oh, there is a good church. I mean, like, where God is moving mightily. And where, I mean, until you go to the church, you really do not know, right? And you can do the same things at home. You can read the Bible, but there is nothing like going to the church and, you know, hearing from the shepherd that God has appointed for you. So I'm very grateful right now to Jesus. The first Sunday I went to the church, I was like, ye to mere ko sab kuch pata hai. These things were taught to me in the church. I know about it. But there was guilt. There was guilt inside of me. A guilt that I cannot explain. And I was dying in that guilt. I was addicted to so many things that the world had to offer. And I was worshipping the devil. Though with my words I didn't say, but with the lifestyle that I was living, I was worshipping the devil. And I was completely at the devil's side. Because if I was living the life that Jesus wanted me to live, then I would be living different, set apart from the world. That does not mean I hate the people of the world. But then I was not living right. I realized it. And then I told Jesus how much, you know, like He knew my heart. It was very hard for me to even confess with my mouth that Jesus, I needed help. When all at that point of time I needed help was from Jesus alone, from God alone. Because no matter how many people I would, you know, speak to, nothing would, you know, like at that time I would be like, and I was the biggest counselor, okay? I knew how much I encouraged people. But from the worldly knowledge, I would never tell them anything about God's word. Because I myself was not living that life, how can I tell someone, right? So, it was my second Sunday. The first Sunday I went, I didn't feel anything. And I didn't feel like, you know, I didn't feel the presence of the Lord itself. Because that was how hard my heart got. My heart was just a heart of stone at that point. Somewhere inside of me, I had that zeal for Jesus. I wanted to come back to Him, but I was so lost. I was in a jigsaw puzzle. I didn't know how. And so it was the second Sunday, and I had an encounter with Jesus. And guys, I cannot tell you enough how that melted my stoned heart. I give so much glory to Jesus that I was in the worship on that Sunday, and I felt a warm hug from the Lord saying that now you are back to me, and now you are never going back to this world. You don't belong there. You never belong there. And he just gave me a warm hug and he told me how much he loved me. And this is tears of joy, okay? And you don't know how much I was. I cannot tell you how happy I was when I got that warm hug from the Lord. It was, he told me that, you know, I was like the prodigal son who got lost and came back to the father. So there is a story in the Bible of the prodigal son, you know, who went away from the father. And he told me that exact same thing, that, you know, you were out in this world searching for everything, but I did not give up on you. And he was very happy. He was not mad at all for everything that I have done. That time I repented again because I did backslide. And thank you, Jesus. So, and that hug, he gave me a warm hug, and then it felt, I cannot put it in words how that meant to me. He just surrounded me with his unconditional love, and then he told me that I was forgiven. He remembers nothing. He remembers nothing. And that's when I said, thank you, Jesus, because that's everything that I could say at that point of time. And ever since then, those words are still, you know, strong in my ears, wherein the Lord told me that you're back to me, and now you're never going back to the world because you never belonged there in the first place. So it was the ending of last year when I went back to the Father, and then, you know, I got rid of depression, anxiety, and panic attacks. They no longer hit me anymore. So that happened on that Sunday. I went back home. I was filled with so much immense joy inside of me that, you know, it's incomparable when, you know, when you have an encounter with Jesus, okay? And if you surrender to him completely and go to the Father, trust me, you are not away from him. He hasn't given up on me, and he will definitely never give up on you. He hasn't given up on you yet. It's never too late to run to the Father. So I didn't get rid of everything just at once, because the enemy, the devil, is a loser, but the devil still tries so hard. And all sometimes we do not realize, and we just, you know, entertain the thoughts that comes in our mind, thinking that, okay, this is our mental health. This is, why do you have to do it everything on your own? Unko de do na. I told this to myself. I was not humble in the first place. Okay, we have to be humble. We have to keep our pride aside. We don't realize, but most of the times it's about I, me, myself. I was one of the biggest hypocrites, I would say. Because, you know, I would always think that, yaar, mujhe ye karna hai, yaar, mujhe ye karna hai, mujhe karna hai, mujhe karna hai. Aur maine ye kabhi nahi socha ki main unke bina kuch bhi nahi hu. The life I'm living now, you know, it is, yes, a life that I have dreamed for, you know, somewhere. But then, I always give credit to myself. I would thank the Father. I would say that, you know, it's all because of God. You know, God ne hi bless kiya hai. Ye sab unke wajah se hi hai. But sachai mein na, main ekdam pride से भरी हुई थी. हम्बल तो बिल्कुल नहीं था. मुझे लगता था मैं बहुत हम्बल थी. मैं ना बोलती भी बहुत थी. और यू नो, यू नेवर नो व्हेन दिस माउथ लीड्स यू टू सिन. Yeah. And so God knew about the condition that I was in. And coming back, I never knew in time where I had that zeal. Before I had so much excuses of not going to church, of not spending time with Jesus. But now everything just comes from inside. Like, I love spending time with Jesus. I love reading His word. You know, all the insecurities have just disappeared in a fraction of second. So God, who is the creator of universe, comes, I'm like, yeah. So He can, now I boast in the Lord. You know, ki kuch bhi ho yaar, jao unke charno mein gir jao, bas aapko pata hi nahi chalega. You would never know, you know, jab wo matlab aise thi kar deta yaar. 3 saal maine struggle kiya hai depression se. I was in the depression for almost 3 years, and I did everything that the world had to offer. You know, it was like I was definitely living for the devil, and I was not even proud of it. You know, there was a guilt that would eat me up. I was fighting battles in my mind that I can never speak to people, and like the devil would put so many thoughts in my mind, like, oh my, that, you know, dying seemed like an option. But I could not really do that. I was not bold enough to kill myself. And, you know, so I got into things which might seem like an escape. I got into partying, you know, drinking, what not the world had to offer. But it never brought satisfaction to my soul because it belonged to the Father. And though it took almost forever for me, like 3 years something, and after which, you know, God found me back. He just pulled me back to the kingdom of light, from the kingdom of darkness. And I cannot tell you how happy I am, because right now the peace I have inside of me is the peace that the world could never offer to me. Because I was never happy in doing what I was doing, that I am not even proud to share about it. Yeah, but I am so proud of Jesus. I boast in the Lord alone. So, you know, there are sometimes you think that your sin is greater, but just know that God's love for you is the greatest of all, and your sin stands null and void. So just go to the Father, surrender to Him, and trust me, you would know. Because I knew of Jesus in between I got lost. I knew Him then as well. But right now the relationship I have with Jesus hits different. And I can say that, you know, with everything I have, I would always live for Jesus here on. Do I have an option? No, I don't. But do I want to do it with my heart? Yes, I definitely do. You know, if God can change someone like me, He can change anyone. You are not too far from the love of the Father. I would just tell you this one thing. Just know that Jesus loves you so much. You know, there are so many good things that I can tell you about the Lord. Because of my experience, and because of the things that I was in, you know, where I thought that, you know, now I'm trapped. Ab to main gaya. Ab to main phas gayi hu. Ab mujhe nahi pata kahan se nikal ke aao. But Jesus had a plan for me. So I'm very grateful to Him that, you know, Jesus sent me a friend at that point of time. And then that friend told me his testimony. And I was moved with guilt at that point of time. And maybe that was the only testimony I required. So it can be different from people to people. I cannot tell you that, you know, ki mere saath jo hua wo tumhare saath bhi same hoga. But one thing I know for sure is that Jesus loves you unconditionally. Jo tum sukoon dunya mein dhoond rahe ho na, the peace you are trying to search in this world, you'll never get it. Trust me when I say this. Maine bhi jiya hai zindagi dunya ki tarah. Maine bhi sabko matlab hum bhool jate hai yaar. Hame realization na bahut baad mein hota hai. So before it's too late, just surrender yourself to Jesus. Just know that the inner peace that you have when Jesus is living inside of you and when you have a relationship with Jesus, not just knowing Jesus. Unko to jante, aap bologe, yes, I know of Jesus, I know of God, you know. But having a relationship with Jesus, spending time reading the Bible, you know, the Bible is a love letter to you. And there are so many things that opens up when you fully surrender to Him. And I was healed from depression, anxiety and panic attacks, and addictions. I didn't even enjoy from my heart holy when I was in the world. But after I came back to Jesus, where I belonged, and after He just helped me get rid of everything, and I started following His word, like it's written in the Bible, seek first His kingdom and all these things will be added unto you. It is not just a Bible verse, I realized it. And I have been telling this to so many people, even I've just shared my testimony to my mom very recently. And I've told her that, you know, the way I know Jesus right now, the relationship I have with Jesus right now, is just something that I cannot put together in words. Because the way I know how much the Father loves me, oh, I cannot tell you, I'm grateful. I'm so grateful to Jesus, that's all I can say. And that's my testimony. I hope you're blessed. And just know that, you know, you are never too far away from the Father. And today I pray for anyone who needs Jesus. Just go to Romans 8 verse 9 and 10. Read the Bible. You know, open up your heart to your Father. Go before Him. No matter what you think about yourself, okay? Because right now it's not about yourself, it's about God, okay? About how great our God and loving our Father is, okay? So just go to Him, kneel down at, and you know, or however, just go in prayer, that's what I would say. And open up your heart, surrender yourself completely. Pray to Him. And if you are not yet in Jesus, if you have not yet accepted, then I would, you know, tell you about Romans. I would tell you about Romans 10 verse 9 and 10. You have to remember one thing, that there is nothing so big for Jesus not to be able to change, okay? You might think that, you know, what about this, what about that? Ek bar ke liye, bas ek bar ke liye chhod do. Aur pura surrender karo. And know this, that without God, you are nothing. And it is not just a mere saying, okay? Jesus died on the cross for you and I. Regardless of what religion you follow, you know, religions were created by human beings, right? So regardless of what religion, Jesus never, you know, Jesus has never written it. Jesus has never said that I died for a Muslim, I died for a Christian, I died for Hindu, I died for Buddhist. Regardless, this religions are all created by human beings. But Jesus died for every one of us, regardless of who you are, you know, whatever who you are, means whoever you are, okay? Jesus died on the cross so that we may live life in abundance. He forgave us. Our sins, our sicknesses, everything was taken by Him on the cross. It is written in Isaiah 53 verse 5. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our guilt and iniquities. The chastisement needful to obtain peace and well-being was upon Him. And with the stripes that wounded Him, we are healed and made whole. So Jesus died on the cross for every one of us, so that we would be able to live our life the way He wants us to live. Jesus has done everything for us on the cross. The only thing that you and I can do is that live our life holy and acceptable and pleasing in the sight of God. And holy does not mean tumhare hisab se, theek hai? Bible ke hisab se. There are so many things that I would like to share what the Lord has been putting in my heart, but you know, one thing at a time. So right now, I just believe that you're blessed by the testimony that I have shared of how Jesus has, you know, saved my life once again and pulled me back to where I belonged. So all glory and praise goes to Jesus and Him alone. And I have zero regrets for, you know, anything. I don't miss the life that I have lived. I don't miss depression, anxiety, and panic attacks, of course. They are not reminded to me at all. And that's the kind of joy I have right now. And I needed to share it to you because right now, it's not about me, but it's about Jesus, the healer of everything, no matter what your circumstances may be. Okay, so until next video, take care, stay safe. This is still me, your very own Faith Lemtur. Bye!